Heard about Noah's Ark? He had this humongous boat packed with pails of all known and unknown animals, all tightly packed. Imagine Noah, quite naturally, in an attempt to save space, packing all the lions and lambs together in one cage. You know, that would be a disaster, because the lions are going to eat up the lambs. Are you aware of a similar situation within our own body? Our red blood cells all look alike, sort of biconcave, floating, moving, constantly circulating with the liquid part of the blood called plasma. If the red blood cells of one person is mixed with the plasma of the same person, nothing happens. The red cells remain suspended. However, if the same red blood cells is mixed with the plasma of another person, there is a possibility that they may aggregate together, clump together, which is called agglutination in science. Why it happens so? There is a guy with the name Carl Landsteiner who wanted to know. In the year 1900, for no apparent reason other than scientific curiosity, Landsteiner mixed blood of two different people, red cells of one person and the plasma of another person, and it just clumped together. Landsteiner continued the experiment with the red blood cells and plasma of different people. After several experiments, he came to the conclusion that the clumping happens because the interaction between something in the plasma and something on the surface of the red cells. This was the beginning of blood group studies. He came to the conclusion that the lions in the plasma of one person does not have any desire for the lambs on the RBC of the same person. If the red blood cell has a salty lamb on its surface, that person's plasma will not have any lion that loves salty lamb. However, that lion of the salty lamb person may like to have sweet lamb. That means somebody whose plasma has a lion that loves sweet lamb that does not interact with the red blood cell of salty lamb. Does it make sense? Depending on this observation, Landsteiner made a classification of blood groups A, B and C. That C is now called blood group O. A group people with salty lamb on their RBC will have lions that like sweet lamb. So there is no problem between them. However, if the salty lamb red blood cell is mixed with a plasma that has the lions that love salty lamb, then there can be interaction and clumping, which again in medicine is called agglutination. This happens in both directions, vice versa. Since Landsteiner was not as imaginative as we are, he did not call them lamb or lion. He called them antigen and antibody. So the person with the blood group A will have antigen A on their red blood cells, and they will not have antibody to A in their plasma. However, they will have some lion, some antibody, but that is not against A, that will be against B. Another person with a blood group B will have B antigen in their red blood cells, but they will have antibody to A in their plasma. So again, there is no problem. Now, we have another group called AB. Blood group AB will have both lambs, both antigen A and B on their blood cells. And they will not have any antibody, any lions in their plasma. There is another variety, original C, now O, blood group O, who do not have any sheep on their RBC. Means they don't have antigen A or antigen B. But their plasma will have lions that can eat A or B. Either way. So since they don't have any antigens on their blood cell, that is called blood group O. In past, we used to give whole blood in transfusion. Currently, we give different fractions as is needed, like packed red blood cells, or fresh frozen plasma, or cryoprecipitate, platelet, different things are given as needed. Blood group AB is called the universal recipient. Means, since they have no antibody to A or B, they can receive blood group A, or B, or AB, or O. There will not be any interaction. Also, blood group O is called a universal donor because their red cells don't have any antigen, neither A nor B. So they will not interact with any of the recipient's blood. In case of inappropriate blood transfusion, the antibodies in the plasma can destroy the blood cells, red cells, and hemoglobin will be released that can cause a kidney shutdown and even cause death. Using these principles of Landsteiner, in 1907, first successful blood transfusion was done in Mount Sinai Hospital in New York. What I describe is an oversimplified version of blood group. More videos on this topic will be coming soon. Landsteiner was the recipient of Nobel Prize in the category of medicine and physiology in the year 1930. But his contributions did not end there. Again, the rest in the next video. If you like this video, share, subscribe, and tell your friends. Thank you very much.